Hi everyone, I'm Todd Maffin. Thanks for joining me for this brief free online training course called Your First Facebook Ad Campaign. I'm going to walk you through all of the steps to create your very first Facebook advertising campaign, track the ROI on it, and some ninja tips as well. And if you want to use a hashtag, it is Todd Webinar, T-O-D Webinar. Facebook is a great place to get in front of people who may not even know that they need your services. That's different than Google. Let's say that you are, let's say that you sell houseboats, and you want to target people who are actively looking for houseboats at that moment, then you would place an ad on Google, because as soon as someone types in the word buy houseboat, your ad would show up. Facebook, on the other hand, is a place to target people by their interests and demographics. So if you rent houseboats out on the for vacationing, you might want to reach people who like to vacation in the summer, who live near your area, but who may not necessarily have thought about using a houseboat. So because they haven't thought about it before, Google would not be a good place, because they won't be typing in houseboat rentals, houseboat vacation rentals, whereas you can reach people who are interested in summer holidays, who are of a certain age, you know, maybe in their early 20s, who like beer, who like sunshine. Literally, you can get that targeted, and I'll show you all about that. The first place to go, though, to start is, if you don't have an ad account, and they're free to get, is facebook.com/advertising. When you go there, it'll create a Facebook ad account. That basically is just a little bucket. You tell Facebook your address, you give it your credit card number so it can bill you. You only pay for ads once they've begun running, so it doesn't cost anything to set one of these up. And then you tell it what currency your country, like what country you're from. So here's how these things work. The blue box is Facebook, right? So on Facebook's site, you create an account by going to facebook.com/advertising. An account has to be tied to a brand page of some kind. So let's say that you, again, have a real estate company, for instance. It will be your realtor brand page. So it might be facebook.com/ABC Realty. You cannot advertise just on a personal profile. It's got to be on a Facebook brand page. But Facebook will walk you through that. Now think about the way, forget about Facebook advertising for a moment. Just think about, if you were a real estate company, a realtor, who would you primarily be advertising to? Well, obviously people who want to sell their home, because you make money that way. You might also want to advertise for people looking for their first home, so buyers. You might also want to advertise for people to staff your office if you're, you know, looking to recruit some people. Each of those three goals, get people who want to buy their home, get people who want to sell their home, and get people who want to work for you, all three of these separate goals can be campaigns. And again, forget about the digital world for a moment and think about it if you were placing a newspaper ad. The ad that you place to get people who want to sell their home is going to be different text, different place in the newspaper than you would advertise for people who want to come and work for you. Each of these are called campaigns inside Facebook. So let's start with one campaign. So let's say a campaign is just a goal, essentially, a goal or a group of people that we want to reach. So the goal of this particular campaign would be to find people who want to sell their existing condos. So you would create an ad. So those are the only three levels in Facebook advertising you have to worry about. Your account. An account contains a whole bunch of campaigns, and each campaign can contain between one and who knows how many thousands of ads if you want. On average, each campaign would be between one and, say, 10 ads. So you create an ad. Let's say that ad says, come sell your condo with us. And when people click on that ad, it goes to your Facebook page. Every ad you create on Facebook, every post that you promote, has to be clickable. And you have to tell Facebook where you want that click to go. So this particular click, we want it to go to your Facebook page. And then we create different ads. Now these ads have the same goal, right? Because they're of the same campaign. We still want people to come and sell their condos. But these particular ads might be very different just in the headline. The headline might be different. Or you might change the photo or the body copy. Still the same overall message, but just done in slightly different ways. This is called A-B testing or multivariate testing, where you will create one ad and then you create variations of it. You set all of the ads running at the same time. You watch those ads for a period of time, and you figure out which ones perform the best, which ones get you the cheaper leads, which ones get in front of more people, which ones drive more business, and the ones that are underperforming, you pause or delete, and then you create new iterations on the ones that are overperforming. That's one campaign. You might have another campaign which Which is promoting, let's say you want to get staff people, right? So it would be a completely different ad. That ad would say, come work for us. And the destination of those clicks would be completely different as well. Instead of just going to your main timeline on your Facebook page, it might go to a specific post on your Facebook page. But what happens if you want people to not, when they click, to not go to a Facebook page? What happens if you want those clicks to go to your website? You can do that. Let's imagine that here's your website here. And it's outside of the blue, so it's not on Facebook. And let's say that you have, let's say you sell ebooks online. So you want people to go to that e-store, right? That store where people buy it. So you create another campaign. This one, the campaign is different. The ad is different because the ads won't say come work for us. They won't say come sell your home because you're selling ebooks. So they'll say come buy our ebooks. So the click destination of those goes to this e-store form. Now here's the really cool thing. This is ROI tracking I'm about to share with you, conversion tracking. The most effective way to know whether or not your ad campaign is working is to measure what business you get out of it. Sometimes you see these on TV ads where they will say, you'll be watching a late night ad and it'll say, you know, buy these set of Ginsu steak knives and ask for operator number 105. Well, there is no operator 105. You've just seen ad number 105. So when they take your order, they put in, okay, that was ad number 105 they saw, and then they track how much money they made off that ad, and then they're able to sort of say, okay, well, look, the ads we did on television didn't do so well, but the ads that we did on radio, which all had numbers that started with 200s, did really well. So we'll put more money into radio and less money into TV. That's called conversion tracking. You can do the same thing if you sell something online or even if you have any kind of confirmation page. Here's what I mean. Think about when you go to buy an ebook or buy anything online, an app or something. You fill out, see that red box at the bottom, the e-store form. So you fill out the form that says, whatever, here's my address, here's what I want to buy, here's my credit card number. When you click submit, you get the order confirmation page. See below that red box? The order confirmation page. That page says, thank you. I got your order confirmed. If your goal instead was to get people to contact you, you know, those arrows would go to the contact form. And when they submitted that, when they actually did the contact form, that's what you wanted people to do, was to contact you. They got a page that said message received. Thank you. That is where you place the secret conversion code. Facebook will give you code that's kind of hidden. And you put it on those confirmation pages. So if your goal is to get people to buy, you put it on the thank you for purchasing form. If your goal is to get people to contact you, you put it on the thank you, I've got your message form. And watch what happens. See the green arrow? Whenever someone gets to that page, it sends a signal back to your campaign that says someone actually bought. So you're able to track it. I'll show you how that works in just a second. So that is essentially it. You need to create an account first. You only have to do that once, and then you do a series of campaigns. So let's do it right now, shall we? Here is my account page, and you get it by going to facebook.com/ads/manage. Click into your account. It'll be your name or whatever name you set up for your account. These are the ads that I've got running right now. And I'm gonna go over here, and I'm gonna say create an ad. So the first thing Facebook wants to know is, where do you want the ad to go when people click? And you really have two choices, inside Facebook or off Facebook. So in this case, I want to promote a particular post of mine. So I'm gonna say on Facebook, here's my page. What do you want it to do? I want to promote a specific post. That means that I want to get in front of more people. Just as an aside, let's go back to my particular brand page and we can see what Facebook wants you to do. So let's see, this one here is a video that I posted about my swarm methodology. It's a YouTube link. And 338 people saw that post that I posted, which was, I posted 15 hours ago. Now I have 2,800 people who like my page. So why did only 338 people see it? Because here's Facebook's dirty little secret. Facebook doesn't show your content to everyone who likes your page. Just because they clicked like on your page doesn't mean they're seeing your content. Facebook actually filters out most of your content and only shows your page's content to those people who liked your page and who engage with your page's content. Now, if you want to find out more about how this works, go to whatisedgerank.com. This algorithm that prevents your people from seeing your content is called EdgeRank. So we want to get in front of more people. So one of the things that Facebook did was they said, if you give us some money, we'll put it in front of more people. And they call that boosting a post right here. So if you click on boost post, Facebook says, all right, we'll show this to people who like your page and all of their friends, and we'll put it in front of more people. And it gives you some suggestions of, you know, the more money you spend, the more people it's going to show it in front of. If you want to, you can say, I want it to be in front of, I'm going to give you $500. So that means you'll reach between 75,000 people and 140 people, or 140,000 people. Or I only want to give you $5. So it says, okay, well, you'll get 1,300 people. Still significantly more than the 338 that I got. And when you do boost your post, you get some pretty interesting stats out of it. I'm just going to scroll down and see if I can find a post that's been boosted here to show you. So here's an example over here. See how on this post on the left where it says 476, this bar is just blue all the way across. Blue means organic. So organic are the people who would see it anyway without me paying. But notice this one over here is, it's a little bit blue, but mostly kind of a light green. And when I hover over it, I can see that the green section is what I paid for. So because I gave Facebook, in this case, $20, it got in front of more people. But if I hadn't have given them, it only would have reached 171 people. And if you click on this little area here, you can find out a bit more about what they actually did. So 12 people engaged with it, they liked the post page, I can see if they clicked on the link and so on. But here is the dirty little secret. I would suggest you never boost posts from the page, and here's why. You can't rename them once you've created them. You cannot track conversions. You can't target beyond a single country, beyond a country. Remember, here when we go to boost a post, the only targeting we can do is to people who like their friends, and that's it. You know, there's no other options that you can do, essentially. So instead, you want to do it from the ad manager. So that's, we'll go back here. Remember, I said I wanted to promote a post from my page. So it says you want more page likes or promote a post. I want to promote a post. Find the post that you want to promote. So it's this one right there. So Facebook will, by default, create two ads for you. One is an ad that's going to go into the news feed. And the other looks like this. And maybe you've seen these before. These are sponsored stories. They're kind of referrals. It's a friend of someone who was targeted by your ad, either likes that ad, likes that post, or commented on it, and it will show that to their friends. Experiment with both. I generally remove these. I prefer my budget to actually go all toward the actual ad itself, but people have different ways of doing it. Okay, so now we've said to Facebook, okay, I want to promote a post, and this is the post I want to promote. Now, here is why you should do it here and not on your page. Remember, when you do it on your Facebook brand page, all you can target are people who like your page and their friends. That's it. You can't target by age or anything. Whereas the kind of work that I do, especially this, you know, swarm methodology about responding to negative comments, you know, your average 14-year-old's probably not going to care about that. So I don't want to spend my ad money reaching them. So I'm going to say I only want people that are 20 years old to, let's say, 55. And it's already suggested the country that I'm in as people. So I'm going to say I want it to be in front of people in the United States, in the United Kingdom, and so on. So we're reaching a lot of people, 166 million people. So let's refine that down a little bit. Remember, the kind of business that I want to generate, the kind of people that I want, are people who are interested in my business. I don't want to target 166 million people because the vast majority of those people couldn't care less about my strategy for social media negative response, right? I want to target people who are interested in that already because that's where my ad money will go. So that's where you put in these precise interests. Facebook will want sometimes these broad categories where you can say, I want to target people who are interested in food and dining. Watch this number drop down, right? Or I want to target people who are interested in news or under family status is cute. I want to do people who are expecting parents or who are have been engaged for 6 months or who have moved recently. You can even target by people. Where is that one? Down, is it family status? Somewhere in here you can target by, there we are, if they've recently moved. This would be good for a realtor, right, to target, if they recently moved and looking for a house. But that's just very general stuff, right? I want even more precise. So you go up here to precise targets, and you start typing in the kind of people you want to reach, right? So I want to reach people who are interested in digital marketing. So I'm going to start typing digital marketing. And as I type, it's going to give me some suggestions. So notice that it's found two areas of digital marketing. It's found this one, which is under the heading topics, and it has a pound symbol in front of it. And it's found this one. What's the difference? Under precise interests, the ones without the hashtag in front of it, under precise interests, these are people who like pages that are named that. So if I want to reach people who actually already have clicked like on the Pepsi brand page, I go down here and I click there. So now I'm targeting people who have clicked like on the Pepsi brand page. So similarly, there happens to be a page called digital marketing out there. So obviously I want to reach those people, so I will select that. But you saw another digital marketing up there, remember? It's this one here under topics. And see, it's significantly bigger. This right now, digital marketing by itself, people who like that page, is only 3,000 people, again, who reach the sort of the market. But here, it's going to reach 5.3 million. What is this page? It's not a page at all. In fact, this is just people talking about that topic. Just people talking about it. So when I hit it, it's going to give me significantly more people. See, now we're up to almost a million people. Now, how does it know whether you're talking about it? Because obviously Facebook has all of your content, right? So if you mention digital marketing on your Facebook wall, or you message friends, you're sending messages back and forth, you're chatting about digital marketing, it will show up. My buddy Chris Brogan, who does a lot of great work around this space as well.
If I want to, I can target people who like his page and say, who live in the same country as him, who are in the same like and like that particular page, 140, or I can say, I want people who like his page and who are just talking about him.
They don't have to have liked his page if he's just talking about him, and that gives us significantly more. So the hashtag signal is your friend. Another way of targeting as well, remember when we went back to here and I did boost post, it said it was reach people who like my page and all of their friends. It used to be Facebook could target just people who liked your page by themselves. And that's really good. You don't want to necessarily spam people. So you can do that. Let's take out all of these things and we'll add a few more countries in. By the way, sometimes I get asked, is it possible to target the whole world? And sadly, no, it is not. You have to go country by country, believe it or not. So you add some countries that are that are there. Another way to figure out the kind of people, the countries that people come from who like your page, is to go up to your page insights on your brand page and click on people and see what countries they're from. So I've got a lot of people from Egypt and India and Brazil. So I want to make sure I get those people too. So India, Brazil, and so on. And the age range. This little require exact match, if you do that, it will get people who are exactly between 20 and 55 to the day. If you turn this off, it'll give you a couple weeks age bracket on either side. So people who are a couple of weeks before their 20th birthday and a couple of weeks after their 56th birthday, it'll include those people as well. You can target by gender. I only want men to see this particular ad, for instance. But here's a way to target just your fans. Put all the countries in, restrict the age to whatever you think is appropriate, or leave it open if it's, if you're a big brand. And now, only people connected to my page. That will reach only my fans, which is really, really cool. It's a great way of doing it. Or you can do the opposite. You can say, only people that are not fans of mine. So this would be a great way of, if you've got an ad that says, come like my page, you want this one, right? You want people that don't already like your page. There's no sense placing an ad that says, come like my page, to people who already like your page. But in this case, I want that ad to go just to people. Remember, just to back up, we're promoting a specific post. We're promoting this post. And I want people from these countries, and you can layer this on, from these countries who like digital marketing. And as you add this, you'll notice that Facebook says, oh, you know what? If you like digital marketing, you might like online advertising. But you want to get those people too? So you say yes. And then Facebook says, oh, look, you're interested in my suggestions. Well, what about these? Sure, yeah, I want those people as well. I want engagement marketing. I want people. No, I don't care about that. I want call to action, new media marketing, pay-per-click. So you can kind of add stuff there. So you can see the flow here, right? I've created an ad. I've promoted this post. It's going to people in these countries who are adults under the age of 55, any gender, who like these topics, and who are already connected to me. Believe it or not, you can get even more targeted. Click this See Advanced Targeting Options, and you can see people who are interested in a particular gender. So if you wanted to target gay men, you would say, I want their gender to be male, and they have to be interested in men. Now, notice what's happened here is that we've reached too small of an audience. So Facebook is becoming a little bit less reliable. So we'll say okay all. And you can say speak specific languages. What's their education level? Where do they work? They have to work at IBM, for instance, or whatever. And now it's going to do the same thing, right? It's too small because we're asking for people from these countries of this age who are male, who like these topics, who work at IBM, and who like my page. So we'll back this out a little bit. So now we've set up the targeting. Actually, I want to get more people in here. So I'm going to make sure that it's any gender. And I'm going to take them no matter what they like. So that's basically any adult who are connected to me in those countries. So that's the second phase, right? So the first phase is to do, what are you trying to do? We're trying to advertise this post. I deleted the sponsored story. Phase two, who do you want it to go to? So we've completed that. And phase three, how much do you want to spend? So this is where, remember back to this sort of campaign and ads. The very first time, let's just go back to this little chart here so you can see. The very first time you create an ad, it's going to create the campaign for you. So you don't have to actually first create a placeholder campaign and then start populating it with ads. The way you create a campaign is you just simply create the first ad for it. So that's what we've done here. We've created the ad. Facebook will give it a name unto itself. I suggest you you rename this to something that makes more sense for you. So this would be to my fans, 20 to 55. And most countries. It's a little bit easier to target that way. And then you say how much you want to spend. So you can say, I want it to be every day a certain amount. If you only want to spend $1 per day, you can do that. And that's the $1 trick. So remember, I said that when you go to your Facebook page and you post on your Facebook brand page, even though, let's just go back to my page here, even though I've got 2,800 people who like my page right now, only a few number of people are seeing it. So what I've done here is I've created this post that goes to all of my fans. But now instead of actually saying, I just want this one, I want to check this one off. Keep my ad up to date by automatically promoting my most recent post. So every time I post an ad to, or create a post on my Facebook brand page, it will automatically create an ad for it and get it in front of more people. And on average, now, lots of people teach this trick. Matt Astavan, who's from webfriendly.ca, I totally recommend you follow Matt. He's a pro in this stuff as well. He recommended this as well. I've seen a couple of other people suggest this. And they believe, although I haven't proven it myself, they believe that the average CPM or the average cost to reach 1,000 people is about 25 cents. So in other words, if you spend four times that much, so instead of 25 cents, a dollar, you'll reach, instead of 1,000 people, you reach 4,000 people. So if you do a dollar per day just to your fans, theoretically, you'll reach most of your fans. Doesn't always work, but most of your fans. So that's one way of doing it. You can also say, I mean, if you want to say, I want to do up to $1,000 a day. Now remember, this is not going to necessarily bill you $1,000 a day because in this case, you know, I'm reaching 1,800 people. It's a fairly small audience. I'm not going to get to that much. So that's just your upper limit. Or you can say I have a lifetime budget, right? So I want to spend up to $350, keep running the ads forever until I've reached that money and then shut off my ad. You can say I want it to start on a particular day and end on a particular day. This is good if you, let's say you have a contest that ends on August the 5th at midnight. So you would say I don't want my ads to run any later than that time. Turn the ads off afterwards. Very helpful. You can, remember back to conversion tracking I mentioned before. Let's go back to this little chart here and zoom past all of these. So remember this little green arrow, when someone purchases something, it sends a signal back to your campaign that says, yes, they've bought it. This is where you set that up under conversion tracking. And we don't have a ton of time to go into conversion tracking here. I'm gonna tell you at the end of this about my Facebook Summer School, where we cover all of that and a whole bunch of other really good details. But that's where you set that up. And then you just hit place order. If you want to, you can change the pricing. You can say, I want to pay by click. I want to pay by impressions. In Facebook Summer School, we talk all about the bidding process, how bidding works, how the auction process works, really help you minimize your price, extend your budget. And then you hit place order. Now, this is where Facebook was crapping out on me during the thing. Okay, so it's working now. So Facebook has created the ad. So the page right here that we're on is the campaign, right? And then here is the ad that we created in it. And if you look, here's a little preview of it, and it tells us a little bit about it. So let's say now that I decide that I want to split test this. right? And I think, I, you know, instead of targeting people that are between 20 and 55, I want to do by young people and then old people and by gender. So just before we get there, see this little symbol here? It means it's pending review. Whenever you create your first ad or create an ad, it goes into a review queue. And someone on Facebook comes along and reviews it, an actual human being. And it makes sure that you're not advertising porn and that your ad doesn't have more than 20% text in it. That's really important to know. If it has more than 20% text in any image, they will reject your ad. Now take a look at this. See my little logo up here on the screen? That's not 20%, so this one should be approved. The way to test it, and actually let me show you a campaign where they disapproved it from mine, is I ran an ad for Facebook Summer School, and in it I put a certificate. So let's see, there it is. And Facebook denied it because take a look at the size of the text here. There is a lot more, let me zoom in here. There's a lot of text in there, much more than 20%. And so Facebook said, uses too much text in the image, so it got declined. You can eyeball it is one way of looking at it, but a better way is to use their grid tool. So here's a way to do, just Google Facebook 20% grid, something like that. You'll get a help page, and on it you'll see a link to the grid tool. So click that. Now it doesn't have any instructions on this page, so it's a bit deceiving. But click choose file. Now this is the image that you want your ad to have, just to double check that it doesn't have more than 20% text in it, and give it that particular image. So in this case I'm going to give it an image of a gift card. Now see, it loads it up into a grid and it says click on all of the boxes that have text in it. So this has text in it. I don't think that really does. This is text, yeah, that's kind of some text too. I wouldn't qualify that, but we're over our limit. So we'd have to come up with a different image. So that's one way that Facebook will do that. So here's the campaign. It hasn't started running yet because it still says pending review. During the day, they're usually pretty quick. In fact, during this webinar, this video, we may actually see them approve it. You'll get a little notification. But look at the ad name it created. So just like it guessed at creating your campaign name, it does a really bad job of trying to figure it out. This is the actual ad ID or the post ID. But remember, what we actually promoted, if we go into it, so click edit so that we can go back into this ad, is we've said, I want to promote the most recent post. That's really what we want to call it. So, and we've kind of done this to my fans, and so we'll just say most recent post. Anytime you do any editing except for the name of it, it goes back into the queue for review. So I mentioned split testing before. Here's how this works. Right now we're targeting ages 20 to 55. Let's change that. Let's go to edit. And we'll go back down to the targeting and we'll say 20 to 40, 20 to 39. That's all we want to change. Notice we've cut the audience roughly in half, which is about what you'd expect for cutting the audience in half. And just go back down here and hit save. So now we've changed that ad so that it's now 20 to 39, but we still want the 40 to 55. So you go down here to create a similar ad. It's going to load the exact same ad up again, exactly the same targeting. And this time you just go over here and you say, I want to change this one to 40 to whatever you want, 58. Place order. So now we'll end up with two ads. And the second one, it'll give it a bad name as well. Actually, it'll just copy the name, essentially. So see what it's done here, is we've got, oops. Remember I mentioned it creates sponsored stories. I don't really like it, so we'll go down here and we'll say delete that particular ad, the sponsored stories. So here's most recent post, and then here's it's guessing at the name, again, poorly. And it's guest post engagement ad. But so we can see here this, and by you, when you click on it, it expands it out. So this particular ad is 40 to 58. So I'll come up here and click edit, and I'll just call this 40 to 58. Close it, open this one. This one's 20 to 39. Whoops. And we'll click pencil there, and we'll say 20 to 39. Ta-da! So now, why do we do that? It's because once this gets approved, which it will hopefully shortly, as these numbers start to trickle in, we'll be able to see which one's costing us less and getting us more business. Really important to do. So let me show you through a couple of these other ads that were that I've created, just mostly to sort of show off. Crazy ads is one, just to show you the kind of targeting that you can do. Let's open this one up. I targeted people who live in the United Kingdom, who are 55 or older, who are women, who like the page called Chuck Norris, and are in the broad category. I mean, it's just sort of a broad, this particular broad category that I selected was parents. So it should list it here if they were smart, but Facebook hasn't quite got around to all of it yet. So it just says the broad category. What it means is, in this particular thing, I said parents. So they have to be a grandmother, right? A parent, age 55, women who like Chuck Norris. And there's only 160 people. Actually, that's a lot of people in the UK that are grannies who like Chuck Norris. And here's the ad I created for them. Chuck Norris loves grannies. What's a nice grandmother doing liking Chuck Norris? Shame on you, shame. And here are the results from it. Now, it reached 77 people. So of the 160 that fit into this category, 77 saw it. They saw it an average of 15 times each, because it's quite a small group, right? And now we cover bidding and placing ads and pricing in a lot more detail in summer school. I'll tell you about summer school in a moment. But essentially, the more targeted, this is very brief, but the more targeted your audience, the more you're going to pay. And the more people that are trying to reach the same group, the more you're going to pay. So there's not that many people who are targeting grannies. So of these 77 people, each of these people saw this ad an average of 15 times. I got 5 people who clicked the ad and 3 of them who liked my page. I don't know why they wanted to like my page, but they did. So this gives me a click-through rate of about 0.5%, which is not bad. And the average price was 83 cents for every 1,000 people, which brings me to a total cost per like of, because I spent 97 cents in total and I got 3 likes, so you divide 97 by 3 and my cost per like is 32 cents. Now, on other ads, which are a lot more targeted, my cost per like could be up past, you know, up past $2 per click. So that's one that I did. I did another one targeting men in their 40s and early 50s who are male, who are interested in other men, so gay men, who like fashion and who live in the US. And I said, hey, middle-aged gay American guy who could probably dress a little better. And I got, that reached a potential of 240 people. 98 of them saw it, an average of 7.4 times. 4 of them clicked, none of them liked my page. No surprise. I did another one here for people who are women who are in Alberta in their 20s, who like bracelets, who are single, and who are gay. So I said, hello, single lesbian woman in her 20s in Alberta who likes bracelets. But notice it wasn't approved. Why wasn't it approved? Because I ran afoul of one of Facebook's many, many guidelines, which is don't promote a dating service with a sexual emphasis. So you can't advertise dating services specifically for gay people. So I would have had to revise this. So this ad never got out. Now you can appeal it, by the way. If you think that it's unfair, you can appeal it. You click on the little help link that it gives you. This is a great read, by the way, the dating rules. And it says, if you think that it was incompliant and not properly approved, click contact us. And then you've got to sort of fill in this form, essentially. But the form is quite helpful, and you do get an answer within within a day or two. And they either explain what was wrong with it and what wasn't wrong with it and so on. So that is that. So again, remember, don't boost posts from the page, because there's a lot you cannot do, right? You can't rename them. Remember how I clicked rename those and I made them pages, things that made a lot of sense? You can't track conversions. The only targeting you can do is by country. So you'll get everyone and their friends who likes anything, even if they don't like your business that you're in. And you cannot multivariate test. You can't create a similar ad. Similarly, you will find on your Facebook brand page that Facebook is always trying to prompt you for this area right here, create an ad. Which basically, sometimes it's called boost page. It basically means I want to get more likes. And it's the same kind of thing. When you hit it, it's a shortcut, right? It's a quick and easy way of doing it. You create an ad, you say how much money you want to give them per day. But again, the only targeting you can do is geographic targeting. But the business that I'm in is consulting around digital marketing, and I give keynote speeches on the topics, right? So who do I want to reach? I don't want just average people, any old person to like my page, because then when I want to advertise to them, it's going to cost me money to reach people who don't necessarily care. I want people to like my page who are interested in the topics that I sell. So we'll do the same thing. We'll create a new campaign. Now remember, the previous campaign's goal was to let's go back to the little grid here. We created a campaign, and the goal was to promote the most recent post. And then we created a different versions of it, right, for different ages. So that was one ad campaign that's up and running. Now I'm going to create another ad, but this campaign is a different goal. This campaign's goal isn't to promote a specific post, it's to promote my whole page and get likes. So here's what we do. Create an ad. Again, what do we want? We want it for this particular page. What do you want to do? I want to get more likes. Now, before we click this one, when you click it, you know, you get a different thing, but here we want to get more likes. And then create whatever you want. You know, you get to create your headline here. Digital marketing, let me zoom this up a little here so you can see it. Digital marketing tips daily. Click like if you want to, whoops. Market Mo better or whatever you want to put in there. And then you can suggest where you want people to land. So when they actually land on your page, you can send them to any of these tabs. And notice on my Facebook brand page, I've got a number of these tabs. I've got the tab talking about summer school, winning a full review. I've also got tabs for conference planners, my website. So you can actually send them to a specific tab. Back in the day when Facebook had the previous version of brand pages, you could do this without buying an ad. Here you can only do it with an ad. So, but this is fine. I only wanted this particular one. I can change this image that it's going to be by uploading it. And once you've uploaded it, it puts it in a library. A lot of people don't even know this, but if you click choose from library, you'll get all the images you've uploaded in the past. So let's say that I want this one. So it puts that image in. Notice it's changed the image there. And again, it's going to create a sponsored story. Sure, let's leave this one up because notice how the sponsored story is different. Instead of it saying Jane Smith likes this particular post, it says Jane Smith likes Todd Maffin, and you've seen these before. So if you want to remove it, you can click remove. So here's again the targeting, right, of this particular page. Now before we were targeting people for a particular to reach a particular post. It's the same thing here. I want to target people who. I want people to like my page who are likely to purchase something from me in the past. So let's actually go to a real world one that I did and you can see how that plays out. So I've got an ad campaign running right now that is called Get More Page Likes. Here we are. And I created this a couple of days ago. And we'll open it up. And this is what the ad looks like. I put .com so that people can type that in. As soon as they click, that's where it costs money. But take a look at this. I've got it right now for people who are 20 to 45 who are women, because I like to split test by gender, and who like any of these. So people who like Mari Smith, who is a great expert in Facebook marketing, who like Chris Brogan, who are members of, or at least like these pages, who are talking about this, who like my agency, who are talking about this agency and so on, and most importantly, who are not already connected to me. And you can see what it looks like by sort of a preview. If you notice here underneath each ad, you can see what it would look like in the news feed. So I'll click that, and that's what it would look like for people in the news feed. This is just a demo. Or you can see what it would look like up here as an ad. So it gives you kind of a sense of what they would look like. And that's it. And then you go off and running and you get some pretty good stats. So far I have spent $31 on this campaign and I've gotten 31 likes out of it. It's reached 4,700 people, almost 4,800 people. People have seen it an average of 1.8 times. So my cost per like is about $1. That's not bad. It's not great, but it's not bad. But at least the people who I'm paying to target to like my page are the people that I care about, are the people who are likely going to be interested in topics like that. If you want to dive in even deeper, I'd suggest you look at my Facebook Advertising Intensive, which is at toddmaffin.com/FBAI. It is an intensive course. You can take it at your leisure, though. It's 7 modules that are pre-recorded. You get immediate access to it as soon as you sign up for it. And here's what we get. Module 1, we talk about advertising without spending a penny. 2, we talk about the right way to boost posts. There's a right way and a wrong way. 3, we'll walk you through in even more detail than we did today, creating and running a successful campaign. Module 4 might be the most important for you. It's how to extend your budget, driving your cost per action down, tracking your conversions, my secret iframe trick that will keep your costs all in line, and then advanced ninja tips, which is gives you all sorts of great tools on targeting your existing customers, getting more customers, A/B testing, and so on. Module 6 is a full Q&A, nothing but your questions answered. And then there are two bonus modules as well. One is how to respond when you get negative feedback on your Facebook page. And the second is all about the new Facebook page insights in full detail, so you can determine how all of these things work out. In total, it's 7 modules. It ends up being about 6 or 7 hours, but you can take it at your leisure, pause anytime. It comes with a complete set of offerings, including a MP3 recording of each session so you can review in the car, complete transcripts of most of the sessions in PDF format, so if you're better at learning by reading, and you get a free sign-up bonus of my book called Bashtagged. It is an incredibly helpful program. I've spent a lot of time developing it. A couple of people have taken it already and found it, as you can see here, ridiculously helpful, already seeing some great results. Monica Hamburg says that even though she considers herself very savvy, Todd brought my knowledge of Facebook ads to a new level. He knows secrets and some ninja techniques that will help you realize your marketing goals. I do hope you'll take advantage of it. Today, just for people on this particular webinar, the price, which is usually $97, I've cut it down to $67, and it comes with a 100% money-back guarantee. If you try these tactics and you don't find any benefit from them, just let me know and I'll refund your investment. It's at toddmaffin.com/FBAI. I think you'll find it a really good use of your time. A couple of other great resources for you. The Facebook Ad Glossary is a great tool to learn all sorts of terms. And also, if you run into problems, of course, feel free to ask me on the Facebook wall. But there's a great forum as well, which is j.mp/FBAdHelp, and FB is capitalized. And you can go in and ask questions of other experts of how you can, I'm trying to run this campaign, but it got refused, and I don't know why. That sort of thing works really well. And every month I draw someone from this contest that I run at j.mp/winfreeconsultation. Every month I draw a winner, and I review their brand page. And if you'd like to be considered for that, just go to j.mp/winfreeconsultation. And that's it, and I'll see you again soon. Bye for now.